Hey, what's up, you guys? It's me, Eclectic Witchcraft. I have wanted to film this video for days, but has literally been raining here nonstop, and it's finally sunny out, so that's my excuse. But with the long-anticipated video, let's just roll right into it. With the summer solstice quickly approaching right around the corner, I thought it would be the perfect opportunity to talk to you guys about simple tricks and hacks, just advice on performing your own outdoor rituals, and some things to keep in mind if it is your first time, if you want to do a ritual outside. So let's just move right into it. The first thing that comes to mind is pests and mosquitoes. Either you think they'll be a problem or not, they will be. So naturally, the advice I give to you is some type of bug repellent spray. Either store-bought or you make your own natural bug spray. There are, I would definitely look into oils. An oil that's known to keep mosquitoes away is citronella oil. You can easily mix this oil with water in a spray bottle and quickly spray yourself to repel any mosquitoes that will bite you all over. Now, if you prefer a natural repellent but store-bought, I highly recommend Burt's and Bees bug repellent spray. It's all natural and you don't have to worry about all those harsh chemicals. Or, of course, you can just buy off spray if you're more comfortable with that. But I figured I should give you some natural options, since us pagans, of course, naturally want to stick with the more natural options. But moving on from pests and mosquitoes, I would also want you to keep in mind is your candles. Candles are a must for any ritual, and of course, if you want to bring them for your outdoor rituals, there's things to keep in mind. Now, I don't care where you're at, you're bound to have wind coming and going, and the best thing I would say is to have some type of candle lantern. Now, you can find these at your local thrift stores, dollar stores. I would check those places out first before you go to Walmart or any other major department store, just for a cheaper alternative. And what this does is, it's a glass, it keeps your candles enclosed in some type of glass, and that will keep the wind from constantly blowing out your candles. Now, if you are low on a budget, you just don't have that much money to actually purchase one for any reason, or you just can't find any in your area, I would recommend LED candles. Now, these are not actual candles that you can light, but the symbolic part of it is there. So those are a good cheaper alternative if you can't either find candle lanterns or things like that. So moving on, I also want to talk about your incense. Now a newbie might be thinking, of course, you want to bring your scents or your charcoal tablets and your loose incense. When you're outside, especially with the wind blowing, like I said, it's best to use incense sticks or smudge sticks. These are typically better outside because they don't easily go out and they're a lot lighter to carry. When you're carrying all your supplies, trust me, you're not going to want to carry a whole thing of freaking charcoal tablets because they're going to go out anyway. And your loose powder is just going to blow in the wind. It's not even going to have a chance to burn. So those are my tips for you. It's simple, but it's effective. Now, another thing I want to keep in mind is I would recommend bring a bottle of wine, then cider, so it doesn't mind being shooken up. Cider will go flat typically when you have to walk to your space, especially if you have to travel out further. Wine, it doesn't really go flat, and it can be shooken up a bit before. So that is my option for you. Another tip I want to say is, where can I even have an outdoor ritual, especially if you're in the city and you don't live in the country with big wide fields of grass? I also live in the city. I live in Virginia. My places that I do outdoor rituals in is like the beach and the park, or my backyard or friends' backyards. Some people, if you have access to a national park, I know some other witches do on Facebook, they mention that, but not everyone lives close enough to a location to go to those places. So if you have, the only place you have available to you is like a park, like a city park. Most of those locations actually close around sunset. So I would say go just before the sun sets. So while everyone's starting to leave, you actually can perform your ritual in peace. Now, if you don't have access to a park, I would recommend, like I said, the backyard or the beach if you have access to it. If not, just keep in mind that, you know, there are prejudices when it comes to us pagans practicing outdoor rituals, and I get that. And you really just don't want people bothering you in general, especially if you're going sky clad, okay? Which means nudity. Also check your local laws regarding nudity, practicing nudity outside, because I'm pretty sure you might get arrested if you don't check this out. I mean, common sense, you know? Another tip I have, if it is allowed to have nudity or performing any sky-clad rituals, nudity, I would say definitely bring some type of blanket. I promise you, at some point, you're going to want to sit down during your ritual, either the before, during, or end, and you don't want to get dirt in your crotch, so on and so forth. Just bring a blanket, because I guarantee you, you're not going to want to lug an entire chair or whatever to sit down, okay? Another thing to keep in mind is where to actually place your actual altar in your space. I recommend bringing just a simple cloth of your altar cloth. That way, it doesn't wobble on the ground and you can just lay your things out amongst yourselves. Now, if you want to bring a table out with you, you're not gonna wanna bring a big bulky table. There is camps tables that are foldable. You can find even small foldable chairs, tables at Walmart, like the ones that you would just have to eat your meal at your couch in your living room. Those work really well. I use those for my outdoor rituals just to place my altar on top sometimes if I want it set up and not on the ground for any reason. So that's my simple tips to you. The last and final advice I have is just when you're bringing all your supplies, unless you have an actual travel altar, that you can just carry in your hand, you're most likely going to have a lot to bring. So I just recommend bringing a simple backpack or a bag like this. It doesn't have to be fancy, just something just to actually carry all your supplies in. It's simple as that. Just, you know, there are things you can do to lighten the load for your rituals. Like I said, the incense sticks and the smudge sticks, just try to bring as little as possible, because I promise you, especially if you have to travel out far just to reach your destination to conduct your ritual, just bring a bag. Because you'd be surprised with all your supplies, like your books, your candles, your incense, any other tools, you know, your books, just, it's going to be a lot. So just bring a bag. And it doesn't have to be fancy, like I said. But that's all I have for you guys. If you have any more questions regarding tips or tricks for outdoor rituals, leave a comment below. I hope you guys enjoyed, and blessed be.